Come in close. Because the more you think you see, the easier it'll be to fool you.
Jesse Eisenberg, welcome to Ireland, and congratulations on the movie. I believe it's just passed 100 million at the box office, so you must be happy about that. What is it exactly about the character of Atlas that you were like, I need to play this role?
That's exactly the reaction I had, because I was doing a play in New York at the time, and I had all this like kind of stage fright, which is, you know, not uncommon. But when I read the script, the character that they wanted me to play was like the most confident stage performer in the world, and I thought that's exactly what I need to do, you know. You know, almost therapeutically, to like get over my fear of performing on stage, is to play a character that's like the most confident stage performer in the world. The character I play is like the greatest sleight of hand magician in the world, so he's kind of developed this arrogant attitude that comes along with feeling like you're really great at something.
Now You See Me has one of the most impressive cast lists of the year, has to be said. Is there any difference in playing a movie where there's so many A-list actors as there would be like a smaller movie?
No, I mean, when you're acting in a movie, you kind of like do this weird trick where you just see everybody as their character. It's helpful when they're really great actors because it's easier to do that. You know, with a movie like this, you know, actors, I think, pretty quickly shed their ego and kind of just take on the role that they're playing, and you kind of see people in that way, which in this movie was kind of odd because my character, like, for example, treats Michael Caine in a very condescending way, and it's kind of strange to, you know, do that with somebody like that. Yeah. So, and also I'm very condescending to Mark Ruffalo as well, and Woody Harrelson and Morgan Freeman. Actually, my character's just really condescending in general, and it's weird to do that with, yeah, I guess, like very established, famous people.
The movie was shot for the most part in Las Vegas and New Orleans and New York. Were there any particular of those three that was your favorite to shoot in?
Yeah, I mean, New York was the most convenient because I live there, but New Orleans was the most interesting city that we filmed in because the movie is about these people who are street performers who are kind of like, you know, illusionists and outcasts, and it was so interesting to work in a city that actually has all those things. Like, it has street performers. I lived in New York and I grew up in New York. I've never once seen a magician perform on the street, but you walk around New Orleans and there are magicians all over, so you realize the city is kind of full of people doing magic, and so it was the perfect place to film the movie.
Magic movies themselves seem kind of difficult to pull off because they're kind of asking audiences to suspend their disbelief twice over.
Right.
Almost, 'cause it's magic, and then on top of that, you've movie magic, like editing and CGI.
Right.
But like, as the film has proven, like, it's still really popular with audiences. Why do you think that is?
Well, I think our movie is popular probably because it's like uses magic as a vehicle for these interesting heists. So like in the first show in the movie, we rob a bank in Paris from a stage in Las Vegas, and we actually do this like live. So it's explained how we do it. So you're right in that the audience is asked to kind of suspend their disbelief twice, but I think it's most interesting in this kind of movie because magic is really just a vehicle for these heists. So we could really be doing anything. It just so happens that we're using our specific magic skills to pull off these incredible bank heists.
You must have ticked off a lot of must work with actors on this movie. And looking back over your career, you've worked with some legends like Woody Allen and David Fincher and Aaron Sorkin. You did an episode of The Newsroom, or you've done an episode
of The Newsroom? Like a one line and a voiceover.
That's enough. Newsroom,
that still
enough.
Counts.
Yeah. Was there anyone else that you're like, I really want to work with this guy or this girl, a director, writer, actor, anything like that?
No, I mean, I would say the most interesting experience I've had is working with a director I've never heard of named Richard Ayoade last year. That was he's English. That was the most interesting experience I've ever had, and I have never heard of him before that. I know he's popular in England, but I didn't know him. And so I've had that experience a few times where, like, you have an interesting experience with somebody you never heard of, and that's really the most gratifying, you know, as opposed to kind of, like, pining to work with somebody and then working with them and then being disappointed.
Yeah, that leads nicely into my next question, which was about Richard Ayoade. You're working with him on The Double. He's huge over here with the IT crowd. You've ever watched that show?
I saw like 15 minutes, but it was odd to watch my boss, you know.
Yeah.
In that series.
What can you tell us about The Double?
Oh, it's a really wonderful movie. You know, he's just a brilliant director. He created this entire world. It takes place in this weird dystopian universe, and it's just so interesting, and I got to play like two characters who are kind of like fighting each other. Like, I played one character and then his doppelganger, and it was so interesting. And I did the movie right after Now You See Me, so it was really great because in Now You See Me I play like you know, this kind of brash magician, and then I got to go do this movie, and the movie I did with Richard is playing this like very meek, sweet character. So it was like, I guess, a good, you know, thing to offset that and pull me down from my high horse.
Also looking forward in your career, I noticed there's a lot of kind of explosive films almost on your IMDb coming up list. You've You've one called The Midnight Sun, which is I believe is about
the people who made the atomic
bomb.
Cute, yeah.
We've one called The Night Moves, which is people who blow up a dam.
Well, very good.
There's another one, which I'm not sure what it's about yet, but I think it's called Louder Than Bombs.
Oh my God, you're right. Wow, very good.
I just noticed there's a lot of explosive stuff coming up. What is it that, when it comes to upcoming projects, draws you into them first?
If they have a bomb. I did a movie last year, called 30 Minutes or Less, where I play a character who has to wear a bomb on his chest.
Yep.
Yeah, these are all real, just unfortunate coincidences rather than some kind of careful planning. I don't know, I look for, like, if I can play a character that has something to it, you know, like, if a character seems like it can exist off the page and exist outside the world of the movie. So, like, in this movie, Now You See Me, I loved playing my character to the point where, like, I preferred playing my character than being me in real life. So at lunch, you know, it's more fun to kind of act like him, like, you know, arrogant magician doing magic for everybody. That's, like, more fun for me, and then it makes the character more fun. So when I am finally playing the character in the movie, it's more interesting. So I kind of look for characters like that I could, you know, really feel like I know fully.
Just to bring it back to Now You See Me, this is your second time working with Woody Harrelson. What was it like just to return working with him again?
Oh, it's great. He's a great actor. He works really hard. He's very funny. In Zombieland, he plays kind of like my older brother, kind of obnoxious older brother type character. And in this movie, we play rival magicians, so we're kind of equal peers who are competitive with each other. So it was fun to work with him, you know, in a different context and different characters, but the same person.
Final question. Considering how well Now You See Me has done at the box office, could you see yourself coming back for any possible sequel to this film?
Yeah, I think it's the kind of movie that lends itself to a sequel because there are all these, like, kind of mythical elements in the movie. Like, you know, we're part of a magic team called the Four Horsemen. This doesn't exist anywhere else in the world. And we're part of, like, this secret organization called the Eye, which is this magic organization which doesn't exist anywhere else in the world. So it seems like those kind of movies can lend themselves to a sequel as opposed to a story about, you know, President Nixon or something where there's, like, a beginning, middle, and end. You know, this is, you know, a fictional thing with cool elements that I'm sure could lend itself to many movies.
Jesse Eisenberg, thank you very much for taking the time to talk to me today.
Thank you so much.
Have a good one.
Ladies and gentlemen,
for our final trick,
we are going to rob a bank.
On the count of three, you will be teleported through space and time to your bank in Paris.
One, two,
three. Everyone in this room was a victim of hard times.
Some of you lost your homes, your cars.
And so tonight,
we're going to return some of that money back to you.
Thank you, everyone. We are the Four Horsemen.
Good night.
Your bank was the distraction while they set up the real trick.
I was $140 million distraction.
Who doesn't love a good magic trick?
FBI! Hands where I can see him.
I don't think I heard you correctly. Did you say magicians robbed the bank?
You are going to be played.
You have what we in the business like to call nothing up your sleeve. Because if you did, it means that you and the FBI and your friends at Interpol actually believe in magic.
First rule of magic, always be the smartest guy in the room.
One, two, three, and...
You want to know how they did it? Say the magic word.
A year ago, these guys were a bunch of street magicians.
Now they're pulling off amazing robberies and not keeping a single cent for themselves.
You do realize this is a game played out on a global scale. Vegas was just a start. This trick was designed a long time ago.
We are dealing with something far bigger than us.
We're all here for the same reason.
We cannot quit now.
Expose them now and destroy them.
Whatever is about to follow, whatever this grand trick is, is really going to amaze. Look closely, because the closer you think you are, the less you'll actually see.